currently, remote desktop solutions such as Citrix and VMware are being inundated due to so many people working from home. But did you know that the original remote desktop solution shipped with Windows NT Server 4.0 in 1996? That was the year that the movies Independence Day and Twister were released. Yeah. Now, just like Hollywood, good old remote computing has also come a long way. So this week from the Microsoft Cloud, the next evolution of VMware on Azure, Azure Container Registry get dedicated data endpoints, and you can create custom roles to your heart's content for the Azure portal. This is Azure This Week, a show hosted remotely since before it was fashionable. So this week, a new evolution of VMware was married with Azure. The mostly Dell-owned application virtualization service is now a first-class citizen on Azure. What does that mean, you ask? Well, sifting through the flood from the gushing fountain of marketing speak, it means the following. Easier to migrate existing VMware solutions to Azure, dedicated support from Azure to set it all up, leverage a hybrid solution if you don't want to, you know, have everything in the cloud from the start, and of course the usual cloud benefits of scalability, elasticity, and bonus cake each November. Hang on, what was that? You want to be in it too? Okay, sure. Oh, thanks, Lars. Yeah, he can sit there. So Azure Container Registry is where all of your major container images that Azure Kubernetes use live. It's a snug home with free Netflix and daily walks. And the containers do well there. Now this week they got a little bit more love. Dedicated data endpoints let you configure firewalls with a fully qualified domain name for the data endpoint associated with your container registry. So before, you had to rely on a wildcard Azure Blob Storage endpoint. Crude. The new endpoints should also reduce data exfiltration risks. Hey, finally, some fresh air. I've been stuck in that studio for weeks. Now, the last bit of cloud news from Microsoft this week is that you can now create custom roles in the Azure portal. Yep. A long-awaited feature. Previously, it was only possible using the command line interface or the API itself to create custom roles. So now, this is an improvement. Jeez. That's it for another farm edition of the show. As we say on the A-Cloud Guru team, when one member decides to create an awful lot of work for the video editors, seek and you shall cloud. So see you next week, and keep staying calm, Lama Gurus.